all people come to him, come to the way of Sultan Al-Anbiya, most honored one and most glorified one, most praised one in divine presence, Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam.
When you are waking up and going, going to work or going out of the house, but outside at night when Mary comes, going back to home, keep remembering Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَدُونَ جَحِيفَةً وَدُونَ جَحْرِيَةً hidden and without doing it loudly. Allah likes the one that who is humble, doesn't say I'm reading Quran or I'm doing zikr, I'm raising my voice for the others to hear me. No, keep low profile. So first sign for the wish is zikrullah, which is إِنَّا نَحْنُ نَزَّلْنَا الذِّكْرَ وَإِنَّا لَهُ لَحَافِظُونَ. We have revealed the Holy Quran and we are protecting it. Protecting the Holy Quran. When Allah says, I am protecting the Holy Quran, means He is protecting the one who is reciting the Holy Quran. Take care of him, because he is taking care of Allah's words. Especially Huffaz, those who memorize the Holy Quran. How much barakah they are between the people. They have barakah around the people who are around them. Because they will be shining like lamps, spotlight in the day of judgment. Not like us, other people who are not memorizing. Now they say, oh, can I memorize? Yeah, you can memorize. But it's difficult. We have this, we have that. Hadith in Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, to recite Qul huwallahu ahad 3 times as if you read the Holy Quran completely. So keep reciting. That's why one of the awrad of zikrullah that the darwish has to do is 100 times Qul huwallahu ahad up to 1000 times daily. That is a sign of darwish. That's the one who keeping zikrullah, holding the Holy Quran. So, since you cannot carry and go to work and come from work the Holy Quran physically, you can recycle or you can recite whatever you have memorized. Now people in the cars, they are putting qasida, which is nice. That why not put Quran? At least you will memorize. Going driving, coming driving, memorizing the CD is playing, the one who is reciting, you can hear him or her, and you memorize. So first sign of a darwish means a simple person, a humble person, a person that's standing at the door of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, at the door of Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, is to have the sign of zikrullah. Awliya Allah, they can see on your forehead the sign of zikrullah, which is la ilaha illallah. When they look at you, they can see on your face, on your forehead, La ilaha illallah Muhammadun Rasulullah. This is especially for Muslim. For non-Muslim, we are not speaking about that. So every mu'min, every Muslim will be written on his head when he is keeping zikrullah. When he is forgetting zikrullah, that it will fade. That La ilaha illallah will begin to fade and then disappear. So awliya Allah, they can see, oh, what happened to this X person? What happened to him? He was there, written La ilaha illallah, now it's fade, it's gone. Means he, Muhammad, he is neglecting his awrad, neglecting zikrullah. God, zikrullah doesn't come with a lecture. That's not zikrullah, that's an advice. Ad-din al-nasiha. Religion is advice, that's an advice. It doesn't take you higher as zikrullah takes you higher. One time you say La ilaha illallah, on the day of judgment, Allah will ask you to do La ilaha illallah. You said, Ya Rabbi, one time you might not go to paradise.
Subhanallah.
Don't say, I listen to advice. I hate zikrullah. So zikrullah is important for those who consider to be darwish. If you want, you don't care for the people what they say. You want angels what they say. If angels see this sign here, La ilaha illallah, they know you are from Al-Zakirun.
The remembering one.
That's why zikrullah is recommended in different tariqah. They do zikr, jahri zikr, because they want people to hear it. Some, like Naqshbandis in their hour, they do sometimes silent zikr, because according to the ayah. That's for zikrullah. But to go for zikrullah, you have to prepare yourself to be clean. So how to be clean is by carrying the Na'ar al-Khairat. The second sign of a darwish, of a humble person, of a person that he is looking for reality. Reality is not how much I have and how much you have. You might be poor, but you are richer in zikrullah, you'll be higher in paradise than that person. Or higher in dunya through the scale of angels. They make, even with little wealth, the angels can make, if you are zakir, angel can make you a wealthy person, happy with what you have, more than what the rich man has, because they might send sickness on the rich man. And on poor man that is zakr, making zikr, no heavy load on him. You become better than the other one. So to prepare yourself is to do Salawat al Prophet, Waqtubiyuta min Abwami. Come to your destiny. Buyut here has many meanings. One of the meaning, destiny. Come to your destiny through your door. Everyone has a door. Don't think that you are going to be the same door. No. Everyone, because everyone accomplished something. Everyone accomplished something. So according to what he accomplished and achieved, he will enter from that door that is assigned to him. Like the example in Holy Quran, this brothers of Sayyidina Yusuf. What could be Yuta? No.
Mutafarik.
Enter homes from different doors. Why? Because you cannot enter from the door of your brother. It's not assigned to you. It has a code. You'll be stuck there. Sayyidina Yaqub is telling them there are different doors. Everyone will enter his door because everyone will be seeing the other one door better than his door. You get jealous. So not to fall into that jealousy in that moment, because Allah is watching them, what they are going to say to Sayyidina Yusuf when they arrive. So everyone has to go through the door that has been assigned to them. So they enter from different doors. You have a different door. I have a different door, you have a different door. It depends on how much you are achieving more or less. If you are achieving more, your goal is different. You cannot, the other one cannot, you cannot pass through it. Can you hold an electric wire? What will happen? But you can, if you wear wooden shoes or something that will, what you say?
Ground insulate.
You, it's an insulation that you can stand on and you can hold even the high voltage, because you insulated yourself through that, so you don't know which salawat will insulate you. Or you, that's why he said to Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, that was Muhammad Mustafa, one of the pious people, that there are 100,000 times. Muhammad Hussain, he read the Layl al-Khairat 100,000 times. He was very happy. He sent it to Prophet and he slept. And in the dream, he saw Muhammad al-Hussain, he saw Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He said, "Ya Muhammad al-Hussain, I will teach you a salawat. It is in the scale equal to 800,000 times as if you have read the Layl al-Khairat. 400,000 times." You see that? He read the whole Dalal al-Khairat. He didn't get that. He gets some other. But Prophet mentioned to him, do this salawat, and there are many other salawat also. Prophet mentioned to many different people and to Sahaba. So you do it, you take 800,000 time as if you have read Dalal al-Khairat. So everyone has a goal. And our goal, it has to be through the Prophet. What to be Utah and Awabiya. Come to homes from its doors. So first Zikrullah. To go to Zikrullah, you have to achieve to open the door. And that door has to be opened through salawat. That's why in Awrad we do salawat on the Prophet from 300 up to 24,000 a day. If you are a dervish, your tongue is busy, your heart is busy, and you are working. You can do that, three of them together. You can work, and this camera has to move this way. You have to work, and you have to do zikrullah, and you have to do salawat, no interruption. A darwish that he gave himself to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala can in the same time do his salawat, do his zikrullah, and do his work. Because he doesn't say, "I'm dedicating 1 hour to read Quran," no, or to make salawat, no. He is continuously diving in the ocean of Zikrullah in Holy Quran and diving in the ocean of Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. So his body, whole body is with that, as Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, "Li sa'atun ma'a Allah wa li sa'atun ma'a al-khalq." Or I have one hour with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and one means one face with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, one face with ummat, a human being. So a darwish who inherit from Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he will find a lot of time, because his body is being continuously becoming zakir. So doesn't need to run the, like if there is a wind, the fan does keep running. So the wind of Zikrullah, that the angel produced this kind of breeze, keep your body in circumambulating in the Kurava, around the whole Kurava. So it doesn't differ from your work, it doesn't interrupt you from your work. You still are going to work. So at that time you will begin to do salawat, and according to your how strong is the salawat that you are following, you will be assigned a door. That will be your door in the day of judgment, that will be your door when you go to grave, that will be your door in dunya. Awliya Allah, they can detect that door for themselves and for their followers. When they assign them to do some awrads, especially some awrads, different from other awrads. And every wali has his own awrad that he learned from Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, because there are 124,000 wali. We follow one wali, alhamdulillah. He guided us, we follow. We don't try to jump from one to another, to another, to another, then you are messing up your doors. No one door will open for you. You keep on one door. That door is the door that takes you to Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam and from Prophet to Allah Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala. So, what we said, you will have first Holy Quran with you, either memorizing physically, or doing reciting, or Qul Huwallahu Ahad. Then, Dalal al-Khairat, if you cannot read, or Qasidat al-Burda, because it's also Salawat on Prophet, or any Salawat, you can do the May Salat al-Ibrahimiyya, or you can do the Allahumma Salli ala Muhammadin wa ala Ali Muhammad wa Salam. You can do that main Salawat that everyone knows. That will guide you to your door. And when you open your door, it never closes. Like you today, you can learn from what's around you. Like these people today, they play games. They go from one stage, another door opens to continue the game. Correct? Correct. It gives you from one stage to another and goes more difficult. So as you are approaching the divine holy level of Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, as you are approaching and that door open, when you enter the door, don't expect it's going to be easy. It becomes more difficult. They want to see you, how much you are patient on keeping your awrad and keeping your normal life and keeping the waridat that comes, inspirations that come to your heart, and to follow what kind of follow you have to follow in order to go higher and higher, and it become so painful, because you see that your goal is reached, you are going to reach your goal, but as if you are looking at the horizon, on the beach, you see the horizon, you sail to it, you reach that horizon, then you another horizon. And you go in the middle of the ocean, where it is water is moving. Awliya Allah, when they begin to dive in the love of Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and from there to love to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they find that difficulty. They feel sometimes, you see people, they come and they say, when we do our rab, we feel heavy on us, is that? You heard some people, they say that?
Yes.
You don't feel that sometimes?
Yes.
Why? Because it's coming more strong. when they are going to open more doors, the power there is becoming not 110 volt or 240 volt or 360 volt. It become with no what you say that the one that produce reduce the power of electricity. Yeah, that you begin to enter the area of transformer, strong voltage. They tell you be aware of strong voltage because you are going to be taken. Like Sayyidina Musa, what happened to him? He was taken. When he said, when he entered that these doors and entered the door of Prophet and entered the door of reaching the threshold of the Divine Presence, he said, oh, I am there now, let me see you. Let me see you. You are not going to see me. Because he asked, you will not give it. What happened? When Allah sent one tajalli is enough on the mountain crashed. Because Allah said, look at the mountain. I will, because he wanted to make it easy to Sayyidina Musa. Sayyidina Yaqub wanted to make it easy to his children. He said, enter from different door. Don't go all of you from one door. You cannot do it. The voltage will become multiplying, increasing. If on one of them comes, let's say, 110 volt, the second one 220, adding on 110, becoming 330 of, and add on top of it 240 and 340, then it will accumulate in one door, and you enter there, you will finish, you will vanish. Like what happened to Sayyidina Musa. When he asked, Allah sent little bit. It was able to finish the whole mountain. So, we have to be careful. When we are doing awrad, yes, sometimes it will come heavy on the chest. And at that time, do salawat. Move to salawat. Salawat always cooling process. Salah ala Nabi is very recommended because sometimes Asma Allah al-Husna is so strong that it carries a lot of majestic power that people cannot carry. But on salawat, that's why in Mecca, the salat there is equal to 100,000 salat. In Madinatul Munawwara is 20,000 salat. 24. It's reduced. Always salawat cool you down like a cool breeze coming to you that you can continue later your hour. So, two signs. You have to carry with you the Holy Quran and Salawat, Prophet Salawat. And the other three, I forgot them. The other, a miswak. Dervish, he said, Ranshir, has always to know that he has to come pure to his prayer and come pure to his zikrullah, because he said, if it was not going to be heavy on my ummah, I would have ordered them for every salah to do miswak. And the salah will become 27 salah, will be rewarded with the miswak. So, third one is to have a physical. With zikrullah is when you begin, you make miswak. When you make salawat, you do miswak. So the miswak is needed, is a necessity as you are carrying ذكر الله in your heart or in physical career, you have the Quran and halal wa khairat wa prophet and salawat. You have to keep always purifying your mouth. Grand Sheikh, may Allah bless his soul, said one time the unbelievers were attacking the Prophet and the Prophet ordered his Sahaba to take their miswak out and lean on one knee and the other one on the air, like that, one on the floor, one high knee, and then Bismillah, Allahumma tahir qalbi min ash-shirk wa an-nifaq. Oh Allah, purify my heart from shirk and corruption. And hypocrisy. And we did that. Allahumma tahir qalbi min ash-shirk wa an-nifaq. That will clear your heart at that moment from any hidden shirk and any hypocrisy. Because when we enter in our prayer, all kind of bad gossips and all kind of wrong things come to our mind from our unconscious, because we are always downloading, you say, downloading a lot of information, bad information in our chip of our mind. So to clear it is with miswak. To purify yourself, to enter in the salawat and enter in the Quran. Then you need a prayer rug to carry with you, a prayer rug, in order that you are ready for your prayers. So what you have to be with you? Quran, salawat, miswak, prayer, and ablush. Siraah al-mu'min, al-wudu. The weapon of a believer is ablush. So you have to have ablution. So these are the signs, ablution over ablution. Even if you do, you have ablution, you pray Zuhr, and you are going to pray Asr, you renew your ablution, because it is nurun ala nur. You become light over light. But sometimes it is difficult to renew, and you have ablution, you can pray. So, ablution is silah al-mu'min, the weapon for the believer. So these are five things to carry with you all the time. Can you repeat them? May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala keep all our breath, every breath we breathe, in or out, with purity, with ablution, with zikrullah, Quran, with salawat on Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, all the time, inshaAllah. Ameen. Wa min Allahi tawfiq. This is very important for us to know. If we want to say that we are darwish, don't say that I am darwish, I am sitting in the corner of the room day and night and making zikr. No, no. Darwish is to make zikr, to read Quran, to do zikrullah, and to make salawat without interrupting your work. At the same time you are working. Means your heart and your tongue are busy. Because sometimes you are working, I give you an example. And you people, when they work, what they do? They put songs. They open the radio or TV and they are working. Their work is not interrupted, but they are still using their ears to hear the music. So why not to hear Holy Quran? It doesn't interrupt. Awliya Allah, they recommend you to hear Quran when you are working, in any when you can, and it will slowly it become like your body react to it by itself, involuntarily. You will feel your heart saying Allah, 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 who, who. You feel it. As soon as you put your tongue on the ceiling of your mouth, the roof of your mouth, that is zikr al-khafi, your heart will work. As soon as you hold one beat to make the shahada finger to move, the importance is the shahada finger, it's not the beats. Because the Wahhabi, they say, oh, you don't do that because these beats. No, the shahada finger is moving here, with witnessing on what you are making of the zikrullah. So it moves on the beat to witness that you are moving it. Or you can move it on your fingers. So it will not interrupt your work. Slowly. At the beginning it might interrupt, but after you become strong enough, then it will be running by itself like a river to the ocean. May Allah make us to run to a river, in a river of divine river, inshaAllah. Buhur al-Jinan, Nahar al-Jinan, inshaAllah. And our dunya will be like that, inshaAllah, running from the river to the ocean. And there you will be a fish floating. You don't move. Fish, they don't move. If they don't, even they don't drown. They can drown. They are already in the ocean. And they are living. How? SubhanAllah. May Allah forgive us and accept from us. Muhammad al-Habib al-Fatiha.